Hi everyone, this is your disclosure. This series of videos is not intended for individuals under the age of 18 or for people who are really religious minded. This is an adult conversation, so proceed with caution. So, welcome back to LaQuanda's Heart. And for those of you who remember, back in the day, I did this huge series called The Holy Wars. And I decided that I wanted to do an updated version of that series and talk about where I am with things. And for those who are watching this for the first time and don't know what The Holy Wars is, The Holy Wars was really a series that talked about my struggle with my spiritual self and my sexual self as a woman. So for anyone who doesn't know, I identify as a Black queer woman, openly. And so, you know, when it comes to, you know, this conversation, I may be talking about men, I may be talking about women, I may be talking about individuals who are masculine presenting. If I have a way to define my sexuality, I say that I am attracted to masculinity, and that is whatever form that it comes in. And I mean that for people who are non-binary, people who identify as male, people who identify as female, just across that gender spectrum there. So, in some of my previous videos, I talked about this internal struggle that I had when it came to wanting to be a sexual being and still maintaining my spiritual self. A lot of that dialogue was related to and embedded in my upbringing in the religion of Christianity. And for those of you who know, I have converted, or I no longer identify as a Christian, but I am moving towards Buddhism. And so it's hard. It's still hard and still a struggle for me. But one thing that I realized that I have stopped and it allowed me to gain more freedom is I don't identify whether or not I'm a spiritual person based on if I'm having sex or not. When I was younger, that was sort of like beat into me, not physically beat, but, you know, beat into my mind that if you're having sex, you're not a spiritual person and you don't have a connection, because sex is supposed to be this wrong thing that you're supposed to wait until you have this union in order to do. And one thing I found is, like, when I would have, you know, sex with people and or sex with someone, you know, I would feel bad spiritually, and then when things dissolved, I would feel bad emotionally because that connection was gone, and I would beat myself up spiritually. And I had to ask myself, you know, what about me spiritually changed during that time? And my answer was always nothing. Like, nothing, you know, I was still, you know, hold true to the beliefs that I had. I was still the same type of person. The only thing that was changing was some emotional connections. And that led me to realize that it wasn't my spiritual self that was suffering when I had sex with someone. It was my emotional self. And when that dawned on me, I was like, wait a minute. Then it's not, you know, my spiritual self that I need to protect, it's my emotional self. And so I began to realize that for me, and you guys can define it any way that you want, but for me, you know, having a sexual connection with someone does not interfere with me spiritually. Not in one way, in any way whatsoever. But it was, you know, my emotions that were, you know, out of, you know, control, and so they would come out of control. And so I had to ask myself, not am I going to have sex with this person because it's going to affect me spiritually, but can I handle having sex with this person and still be emotionally okay? And I found out if I could not answer that second question, if I could not respond to that question with a yes, I'll be okay, then I knew that engaging, you know, in a sexual relationship with that person was not the best thing for me. And it took a lot of hindsight and a lot of meditation and a lot of moments to myself for me to realize and to understand that I needed to make sure that emotionally that I was okay after dealing with people. There was a particular instance where I just knew the universe had brought someone into my life. I was so excited. I was so happy. And I did not ask myself that emotional question. And when that dissolved and how it dissolved, my trust in the universe and, you know, spiritually began to decompensate. Because I didn't stop and I didn't stop myself and say, hold up, wait a minute. You know, does this person really need to be in your life? See, that is the spiritual, for me, that is the spiritual question right there. Does this person need to be in your life? And that is the question that you ask, you know, in the beginning. You know, is this person, you know, worth the investment? Is this person supposed to be near me? Am I supposed to be connecting with this person at all? You know, before, you know, a physical connection even comes on the question, on the table. Like that, for me, that's the spiritual realm of things. But when I'm starting to think about, you know, a physical connection and sex, you know, for me, that's more of the emotional realm. And when I am in that, you know, emotional space in this particular situation where things didn't work out, I was devastated and I was affected, you know, spiritually, not because I had sex with the person, because I did. It was because of I did not ask myself those key core questions in the beginning. And that is what rocked me spiritually. And so I learned for myself to separate the two. And I was like, you know, I have to keep these two planes separated, my spiritual self and my emotional self, because they don't exist on the same plane for me. And when I learned to do that, I began to filter out the people who, and you know, and I let my spiritual self speak first, and I began to filter out, you know, people and experience who could reach me and connect with me on an emotional level. And then once that emotional level was set, then to determine whether or not someone can connect with me on a physical level. But that had to, you know, that had to happen. I think that for me, you know, I am raising a daughter. However, she's not being raised with any type of religious upbringing. I tell her about religions. I let her know about all religions. If she asks me a question, I'll answer those questions for her. But for me, when it comes to, when I have conversations with her about sex, when I have conversations with her about emotions, I am asking her to ask herself, how are you feeling in that moment? How did something that happened make you feel? Did it make you feel uncomfortable? Did it make you feel unsafe? Did it make you feel good? If it made you feel good, what did you like about it? You know, and breaking down those things to determine, you know, are these superficial things? You know, so that she can at an early age begin to decipher and learn how to work through the emotions that she's feeling and identify, hey, this right here gives me pleasure and this right here does not. And for me, that's very, very, for me, that's key. for me, it took me a long time because I was so busy when it came to sex operating in that spiritual realm that, you know, if I had sex with someone, then that was going to develop, you know, these, the way I was taught, you know, like these are going to develop these soul ties and these connections. And I had to ask myself, was like, is it really a connection there? Because you got it spiritually attached to this person somehow. Which the answer, when I asked myself that question, the answer 9 out of 10 was no. Or was it because you develop an emotional connection to someone that should not have been there in the first place? And generally, it was that second half. Again, developing emotional connections that should not be there in the first place. Now, for me, am I saying that I exclude any aspect of spirituality when it comes to looking at and developing connections? The answer is no. Because remember, you know, I'm looking at that front end, and I'm honestly just now getting out of, or I had to go through a situation that I should not have had to go through if I would have simply did that spiritual front end, where I'm asking, should this person really be here? You know, should I really have this connection? And, you know, we want to ignore that because we're so excited that someone new is there in our life and we want to be connected to people and things like that. And it's like, if we would have did that, is the spiritual part. And I think we have been taught, and I'm just going to say a lot of I have been taught that the spiritual part goes around the sex. You know, that, ooh, you have sex, you're going to hell. And that's just not me anymore. If I'm emotionally ready, then I will. And if I have a physical connection with someone, then for me, that does not impact me spiritually. Because I'm still going to maintain my spiritual self regardless if someone is present or not. And that is the whole thing for me. I don't care who is here or who is not here. I am going to be myself. And I am going to maintain my spiritual connections. It seems like sometimes when it comes to, you know, us as women, we always want to work on ourselves, and particularly our spiritual selves, when someone leaves or there's a breakup or something happens. When working on your spiritual self, your emotional self should be a continuous thing regardless if someone is there or not. You know, someone once told me, oh, LaQuanda, you move so fast when it comes to things. I was like, not necessarily. I already have a therapist. I already talked over the issues that I go through. I already identify, you know, the problems and the things that I have. While you're getting started, just because something ended, I'm continuing the work that I do regardless if I'm by myself or not. And that's the point and where we have to get. We have to work on our spiritual selves and our emotional selves and our physical selves regardless if someone is there or not. So for me, separating my spiritual self and emotional self really, when it came to sex, really did help lift a lot of pressure off of how I see things and allow me to have experiences that I have truly enjoyed. And, you know, it's still an ongoing process, which it always will be, but I'm happy where I've landed. So far, it's continuous learning and learning myself emotionally, and that's where I'm at. So thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions, you can have them below. I'm going to try to make this all one long video instead of just breaking it up into a series. So I will see you guys next time. Bye.